becomes a thumb.
Each of you are probably asking a lot of questions in your head right now. How will I do? Will it be harder than I thought it was? Will it be too easy? Will it be just a grind, or will it be some fun in it? Will the people in my crew support me? Will they accept me? Will they care about me? Or will I just make a fool of myself, and so forth? How will I handle solo? How will I do on the ropes course? I'm sure you have a lot of those kinds of questions, and you'll probably have a lot of questions that you haven't even begun to think of yet. But you can't fail here, so don't worry too much. You don't have to worry about failure, because all we ask is that you give your best, and you alone, know what that is. You don't have to beat anybody else. You don't have to climb faster. You don't have to race to the top of the rock or be the first person across the finish line in the marathon. What you have the chance to do is your best. You see, we at Outward Bound believe that human beings, you, me, all of us, have potential that we never use. We can do so much more than we think we can. And perhaps, just perhaps, if we discover this just once, things might be different with us for a lifetime.
Yes, mama, mama, take a look at this. She's out there on the levee doing that double two. Wine and bone, dog, and I'm a man.
And come around to this ledge, and then you're home free.
I have to
that rope over my arm now. What? Don't go fast. Take your time. Take your time. Good boy.
Now up rope two.
Up rope two! Not too much! All right, good boy. Now shift slow. This is where it's... All right, now keep moving out. Good. All right.
Yeah,
nice move. Now shuffle your feet up.
Oh, great.
Push. Push. The slack, too! A little more! Pull it off the rock. All right, now flip it up out of that crack.
Good,
good.
Get you
off the track. Now you just go straight up there.
In order to explore the outer limits of what your mind says is impossible and what your body says it can do, we teach rock climbing. At the end of a companion's rope, you experience the thrill of doing a climb, the joy of moving well on small holds, and the trust of another's word. You apply techniques to increasingly difficult problems and learn how to think creatively. You must make decisions and back them to the hilt, because the rock gives no quarter. And when you complete the ascent, the victory is not a defeated mountain, but a greater understanding of how you react at a critical moment. It's the discovery of yourself and others on a knife edge of existence.
Now put your right hand on there, just like you got it. Okay, good. And your left hand up on here. Your left hand is just going to be for balance, okay? Keep it from going to side to side. But this is the important hand. That's your brake hand. Okay? So don't let go with this hand. But you don't really have to do much. Most of the friction is taken up in this thing, okay? So just hold on pretty tightly with this and lean back, and then when you want to start going down, just loosen up your grip on that and let the rope slide through the figure of eight, okay?
Thank you. You've long been on the open road, sleeping in the rain. From dirty words and muddy cells, your clothes are smeared and stained. But the dirty words and muddy cells will soon be judged insane. So only stop to rest yourself till you are off again. And take off your thirsty boots and stay for a while. Your feet are hot and weary from a dusty mile. And maybe I can make you laugh, maybe I can try. I'm just looking for the evening, the morning in your eyes. But tell me of the ones you saw, as far as you could see. Across the plains from field to town, a marching to be free. And of the rusted prison gates that tumbled by degree. Like laughing children, one by one, they look like you and me. So take off your thirsty boots and stay for a while. Your feet are hot and weary from a dusty mile. And maybe I can make you laugh, maybe I can try. I'm just looking for the evening, the morning in your eyes.
After Solo, it felt as if I knew the forest and the mountains. But of course I didn't. What I knew better was myself, and the forest and the mountains had helped.
Because our society is becoming more and more complex and appears to be debilitating the human spirit. Because it is easier to repress than to solve problems. Because we are killing that very environment which sustains us in life. Because all of us are losing a sense of compassion for one another. Because life abounds, but most of us seldom see it. And because life is not full of kicks. But there has to be some kick in life if it is worth living.
In my mind, I'm gone to Carolina. Can't you see the sunshine? Now can't you just feel the moonshine? And ain't it just like a friend of mine to hit me from behind? Yes, I'm gone to Carolina in my mind. Karen, she's a silver sun. You best walk her way and watch it shine. Watch her watch the morning come. A silver tear appearing, now I'm crying. the finest thing around. Whisper something soft and kind. And hey, babe, the sky's on fire. I'm dying, ain't I? I'm gone to Carolina in my mind. In my mind, I'm gone to Carolina. Can you see the sunshine? Can't you just feel the moonshine? And ain't it just like a friend of mine? Hit me from behind. Yes, I'm gone to Carolina in my mind.